Morning, everyone. First this morning, hundreds of police barricaded the Grocon Meyer building site in Melbourne overnight ahead of fresh protests. The ugly industrial dispute between the building giant and the unionists has now entered its third week. Ted's Ben Lewis is at the site for us this morning. Ben, very heavy police presence behind you again there this morning. Any sign of violence this morning?
Ron, fortunately not. There were a few tense moments in the early hours, but it's been an otherwise pretty peaceful morning on the picket line. As you said, you can see behind me about 100 or so still guarding the Meyer site in Lonsdale Street, vastly outnumbering the number of CFMEU workers still left. Only a couple of dozen or so. They say they'll return tomorrow morning, apparently in even stronger numbers. We understand that Grocon did manage to smuggle in about 20 or 30 non-union workers to the site, although we haven't actually seen the cranes moving. This morning, union leaders pleaded with workers not to show any aggravation towards police, and the huge show of force that it was, with a couple of hundred, including mounted police and the special operations group. The union bosses say that scenes like we saw last week do not help their cause.
Ben, this has been dragging on for 3 weeks now. Any possible sign of an end?
Well, not at this stage. Both sides need to get to the negotiating table for that to happen, and that looks as far apart as it has been so far throughout this entire saga. Last night, the CFMEU made a new offer, a compromise deal, saying that they would indefinitely postpone the industrial action if Grocon came to the table. Grocon then refused this offer, saying they don't want the action to be postponed. They want it abandoned completely because they say it is illegal. This has been running now for more than a fortnight. We spoke a short time ago to the union's Bill Oliver, who says it may drag on for weeks yet.
This is going to be a long argument. I mean, the sooner that Dino Gullo will come to the table and sit down and try and end it, it will end.
And Ron, today the battle moves from here on the street to the courtroom. Grocon and the state government trying to have the union held in contempt of court.
OK, Ben, thank you. Ben Lewis reporting from the Grocon site in Melbourne CBD. We'll be right back.